day that many of us will never forget.
Into the other tower.
The fear. The tragedy. And the resolve.
Thank you, guys!
20 years later, the emotion still real for so many, and the hope of returning to a feeling of unity.
God bless America.
You are looking live at Ground Zero. There are two beautiful reflecting pools where the Twin Towers once stood. As we approach the 20th anniversary of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, the pain is still fresh in the mind of retired New York City firefighter Jerry Sanford.
Sanford retired to Naples more than two decades ago, but an old New York City firefighter helmet brought him back to New York City the day before the attacks and changed the course of his life forever.
So I see and immediately know it's from the South Bronx, because that was the fire commissioner's old firehouse.
It started with a helmet. Jerry Sanford's retirement in Naples would be put on pause by the discovery of an old firefighter's helmet that somehow ended up at a firehouse in Pelican Bay.
Hundreds and hundreds of firefighters show up for the rededication, including Mayor Giuliani, all the officials I worked with, and Father Judge.
His journey to return it began September 10th, 2001.
My dear friend, who was one of our Catholic chaplains, they had an altar set up on the apparatus floor. Who would have known at the time that was the last mass he said?
The firehouse dedication would be the last time Jerry saw the chaplain and so many of his brothers in the FDNY.
I look up, oh my God, a tower's on fire. Thinking, what the hell is going on? I'm thinking, I know what the firemen, they're going in, they're going up. Everybody's coming out.
Jerry was at the airport on his way back to Naples when the unthinkable happened.
Pandemonium. I have never been in a situation in my life. Pandemonium in Pittsburgh Airport. People running, Kelly, screaming, out of control. And we're standing there like, what's going on?
All he could think about was going back.
Oh, my God, the tower collapsed. Oh, my God, no. I saw these being built in the 60s when I was going to Harlem to my first firehouse. That couldn't be. Now, I don't know, 20 minutes ago, the second tower comes down.
At that moment, he knew.
Forgive me a moment. I see this cloud. The towers are gone. How could they be gone? How could they be gone?
Jerry returned to New York, resuming his job as press secretary for the fire department. He coordinated news conferences and funerals. So many funerals.
Most difficult thing I had to do was to go and knowing the wife, you know the kids, and here, if they even found a part of them. I mean, some of them were pieces of the firefighter.
The old helmet had changed the course of his life, taking him out of retirement and giving him the most important mission of his life. And 20 years later, he knew he needed to document his journey.
Why was this story important?
Because people have forgot about 9/11. It's like, you know, hardly anybody flies a flag. You couldn't buy a flag to fly it 20 years ago. And we were all one. We were like one neighborhood. We were all New Yorkers 20 years ago. And 2 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, didn't matter. There were strangers standing there. USA, and cheering us.
Thank you, guys!
And that's how close everybody was then.
He's hoping his book, It Started With a Helmet, will show young people that America used to be different.
I don't know if it was the war, I don't know if it was the social change or what, but it's like I'm afraid to mention 9/11. Like, you know what, you know, that's terrible. It was completely reversed 20 years ago, when we all hugged each other, loved each other. You know, it didn't matter if you were from Colorado or from Minnesota or here or New York. You were all together.
I've known Jerry for more than two decades, and the afternoon we spent together this week was certainly emotional. You know, my sister lived just 4 blocks from the towers, and we couldn't get in touch with her for hours. And I'll never forget the agony of not knowing whether she was okay. And for Jerry, he lost so many of his colleagues, and he went back to help, and he's sharing his story now, and it's a good story.
It's a really good story, and he's a great guy. You can tell just by hearing it. Oh.
And something our children can learn for, too. Yeah. You know, a nation divided, bringing people together.
My kids are to the age where they're asking me questions for the first time about 9/11, and it's a difficult thing to explain to the kids because, I mean, it was just so
tough. But after, we were so collective, and we were all Americans. If you're looking for a way to honor the victims, we've listed the many ceremonies happening this weekend on our website, nbc-2.com. There is also a link to order Jerry's book, It Started with a Helmet.